Bogus Charities. There's a lot of sound-alike charities, and I hate to admit this, but when I started at the Bureau, I was donating to a number of charities for paraplegics, because I've got a friend who's a quadriplegic, so I have a soft spot in my heart for anything like that. And so I looked them up when I got here, because I said, be careful of bogus charities. And 4 out of 6 of them were not real charities. They were societies, they did exist, they did have a purpose, but they were not charities. So they did not have a charity number under the Canadian law. And I had not paid attention to how they were using the money. So they weren't actually using the money for the paraplegics. They were using the money for something else. And there was only a small portion, 15-20% of the money, was going for that use. We've had recent problems with look-alike CNIB charities, where they pretend to be the CNIB, but they're not, and other door-to-door charities. So it's actually a business that sells books that are good for children who are waiting for hospital treatment, and it's just supposed to entertain them. And they say, we're raising money for your hospital. And one of the places we heard about it was the Salt Spring Island resident phoned and said they'd been called to raise funds for the pediatric department of the Salt Spring Hospital, which there is no such thing. And what they really were doing was selling these books. And the books did go to these offices, but the question was, is that what you wanted to do? Send your money to a company who's actually selling books versus sending money to a charity that you could define is using maybe 70, 80, 90% of the money for a specific program that you care about, and not a lot of it being overhead. These other ones, they're a profit-making company, and probably less than 10 or 20% of the money you gave out actually went to help any child.